as with the FNAF 1 review, it's time to review another holiday themed video game, and this time around we have this game, Metal Gear Solid. Released in 2006 by a huge Metal Gear fan by the name of Arthur Lee, Metal Gear Solid is a holiday themed Metal Gear fan game he created as an entry into a Christmas themed video game contest, and he ended up taking first place. And I have to say that that first place trophy was well deserved. This game is a gift. No pun intended. And I'm not the only one who believes this. Many others online, like Somebody Call Me Johnny and countless other YouTubers, have said that if you're a huge fan of the Metal Gear franchise, you need to check this out. And because Christmas is already here, the timing seems perfect. Starting off with the first title in the series, Metal Gear Solid Secret Santa, the story follows Saint Nick himself as he continues with the tradition of handing out gifts to all the little good boys and girls. But this year, there is a change of plans. Because of the 9/11 terrorist attacks, air travel across the United States has been greatly restricted, meaning that he has to give out gifts the old-fashioned way, by foot. His late-night adventures then lead him to this mansion, and yes, I put that in quotations because even though it's supposed to be a house, look at it! It's so huge you cannot call this a house, it's a mansion. Anyway, that's all I'm gonna say in terms of story to prevent spoilers. This game is filled with many references to both the Metal Gear franchise and popular culture as a whole, and the humor for the most part is on par with the franchise, and I'm okay with that. It has its moments, and it shows that this game has a lot of care put into it from the voice acting alone.
Your dots get refilled every time you enter a new area. Wait a second, that's completely unrealistic. Are you seriously complaining about realism in a game about Santa Claus? Wait, what are you implying? Nothing. Bye.
In terms of gameplay, it's very similar to that of the Metal Gear games from the MXS, as well as Metal Gear Ghost Babel. It's a top-down 8-bit game where all you do is navigate Santa through 10 levels of the house, whilst avoiding getting spotted by children who are still awake, trying to get a sneak peek at their Christmas presents. There are various ways to get by undetected. Most of them are from using the items scattered around the house. You use the arrow keys to move Santa and the control key to perform actions like banging on the walls, and to use other items you can access via the shift key. Sometimes you'll need to smuggle a candy cane to see laser traps, or a camera flash to temporarily blind kids that are in your path. The idea of making a Christmas game around stealth based on Metal Gear was a stroke of genius, because it makes total sense your Santa would need to be completely out of sight, especially since he doesn't have a sleigh to his advantage. But be warned though, we're playing by European extreme rules here, meaning that there is no alert phase, so when you're caught the game is over and you have to start from the last checkpoint. And if you don't know how to proceed, you can always use the Kodak feature to call your assistant, Tiny Tim, who can in turn give you advice. And that's pretty much it. This game is very short. It took around 30 to 35 minutes to complete, and it only consists of the stuff I said earlier. It's a well-crafted Metal Gear fan game that not only pays homage to the series, but also does it in a special way. In fact, the game was so well liked that it earned itself a sequel in the form of Metal Gear Solid 2, The Ghost of Christmas Past. The story this time around picks up where the last game left off, and before I go on, I just have to say that this next part does contain spoilers for the ending of the first game, so if you don't want to be spoiled, just stop the video right now, play the game, and then come back. Okay? Okay. See, at the very end of Metal Gear Solid 1, Santa is ambushed by Solid Snake himself. Snake then informs Santa that he's actually the long-lost brother of Big Boss named Big Beard, who apparently was part of his secret project to create the perfect beard. Right. Now, at first, you may think that that's pretty cool. Big Boss's brother was actually Santa? That's pretty cool, right? Wrong. I'm assuming that this game happens somewhere after Metal Gear 1 and 2, because Snake still has some pretty bad PTSD from those events. Because of this, he can't trust Santa to go free, so he kills him on the spot, and then the game just ends. That's it. The credits roll. But of course, this will only be the beginning of something much more greater. Going back to the second game, the assassination of Saint Nick causes the SOC to totally collapse, millions of PNCs to rise up. An extremist group by the name of the Ghost of Christmas Past seizes the opportunity and plans to use the chaos to get control of Santa's hat to balance the number of naughty nice kids the way they see fit. So, to set things right, Snake then heads to the Outer Savin Mall, very clever, to put a stop to their plans, this time with the help of Otacon on the codec. As you can probably tell, the narrative is slightly more complex this time around. Cutscenes go on for way longer than in the first game, and you will spend often a lot of time in codec listening to conversations and figuring out what to do. But like the first game, Metal Gear 2 continues to poke fun at the silly side of Metal Gear while also being its own thing. And it gets better with the gameplay. After quickly becoming used to the simplicity of the first game, I instantly recognized many upgrades in game design. For example, the Soul-Time radar system makes an epic return, there are more areas to sneak around, more items to use, and more security measures to outsmart. We have a bigger and better game here, and it definitely takes the cake as one of my favorite fan games of all time. I was genuinely hooked on this game. It's a pleasure to sneak around to various areas and to get into all sorts of shenanigans, and of course to hear the banter between Snake and Onicom whenever the opportunity arises.
Got it. One last thing.
What is it?
Candy canes go in the mouth, not through the windpipe. You got that?
However, there is one thing that annoys me. After getting very far into the mission, you have to backtrack all the way to the beginning of the game to get an item to advance.
I don't have time for this.
And they play it off like it's some joke, but it's like, dude, come on. It's a serious pace breaker. Other than that, Metal Gear Solid 2 builds upon its predecessor with even better gameplay and a stronger plot, and continues to use the Holiday and Metal Gear as a base and pass with flying colors. Not only are the graphics nice looking and clean, but the music strikes a good balance between Metal Gear and classic Holiday jingles. These are fan games that are worthy of playing, and like I said earlier, if you are a Metal Gear fanatic like I am, play them, you will not regret it. I give both of these games an A out of 10. And if you want to experience them for yourself, look in the description. I placed the link to Arthur Lee's website where he has both games available to download. They're free, don't worry. And for everybody else, happy holidays, and I'll see you in the next video, comrades.